What just happened?
We were eaten by an Earth Pulse.
This happened to you before, didn't it?
It's different this time. It looks like our awakened friend Enominat is using the land as his vessel. In other words, this Earth Pulse is now part of his body. I was able to flee him only because I found a rift in the Earth Pulse as it formed.
So, Velvet and the others?
I guess I won my bet. Took long enough.
Bravo! You do have a talent, if nothing else.
Oh, Melchior. If you're here, this place must be more important than I suspected.
Move aside. I must close this Earth Pulse rift.
Bienfu, protect the rift!
Do well, and I'll forgive that little betrayal of yours.
But if you run, my curse will follow you for eternity!
Bien! You got it!
It looks like I just won my bet. If I let you seal this rift now, I'll never collect. Illusions won't work on me. You can't break a heart that's already broken.
That day, I interrupted my art when your heart broke. I suppose I was taking pity upon my student. But this time, know that I won't hold back. I will grind your heart into dust!
You're awake! I'm glad to see you're okay. It looks like we got sucked into the Earth Pulse.
Are you all right, Eleanor? What about everyone else?
I'm fine. But...
Kill. They killed so many. Murdered. Slaughtered. It was all for him. I killed for him. But he said I was ugly. Nothing. All for nothing. I can't. I have to kill. Die.
The whole time, she...
You're awake. Come on, we're leaving. I have to kill them.
But Enominat is your...
It's just an illusion! A fake! A trick!
Or... What if it was really him? Then that means he betrayed me, doesn't it? You think I can't kill a traitor like him? Why wouldn't I? Just how many do you think I've killed? You, who watched me do it!
I'm... sorry.
Velvet!
Luffy, time to wake up.
I told you to stop calling me Luffy. I'm not a little kid anymore.
Grumble, huh? You must be feeling good.
Enominat!
A bit of a fever, I'm afraid.
No, this is
at
different.
Least the new medicine's supposed to come today.
A vision of the past?
Until then, you stay in bed.
See? I killed him! It was easy! I'm used to it by now. All right, we're getting out of here! With your power!
But...
Now!
We've gotta find Aizen and the rest!
I said now! Enough! Stop it! They're the ones who need to be stopped! Isn't that right? I'll kill them! I'll kill them all! You must calm down.
Fine. I'll calm down and look for an exit. That's what you want, right?
The case. We have to get out of here. Let's keep moving for now.
Yeah, I guess so.
Are you all right, Lafayette?
Yeah, I am. But I'm worried about Velvet.
This may be more than he can bear. Not that I blame him. Lafayette, perhaps you should rest within me for a while.
No.
But if you don't, then...
I know. But if I hide, it'll only hurt Velvet even more. I should at least be at her side.
You really have become stronger.
But I haven't. I hate it. But there's nothing I can do to help Velvet now.
Of course there is. Having someone nearby can be all the help you need sometimes. Like when I lost my mother.
Eleanor...
So, let's keep an eye on Velvet while we search for the others, all right? Just remember that I'm always with you, Lafayette.
I know. Thank you.
Are you ready for this?
No mercy! Wounds that will shoot its heart in the flesh!
Really?
We will need to be extremely wary.
Down! Right of left!
what am I...
Are you ready for this?
We will need to be extremely We will need to be extremely wary. That boy who called himself Enominat. Could he really be Velvet's younger brother?
It could have been an illusion intended to torment her. Don't you agree, Eleanor?
I do. Velvet's objective is avenging her brother, after all. We've all seen how strongly she feels about it. I find it hard to believe that the one so dear to her is still alive.
I don't know what powers Enominat possesses, but I think that really was her little brother. Velvet was able to see past Melchior's illusions.
but look at her now. I just don't want to believe that the real Lafi could do such a thing.
Could it be possible that Enominat was reborn into her brother's body?
I don't know. But if that was the case, I'm not sure Velvet would be in so much agony.
Yes, I guess. Enominat actually being Velvet's brother. It makes a twisted sort of sense. But it's too awful. Are we ready for this?
Rising Falcon! No mercy!
Come on, really?
I don't think we have a deal!
Is this?
Look!
with me. I'll get someone right away.
It's okay. I'm tired.
Have you been journeying long, then?
10 years. My master entrusted everything to me. But I couldn't do anything.
10 years?
My wings are weak. It doesn't matter anymore.
I see. If you've been working that hard, you surely need a break. I just happened to get my hands on some prickle boar meat. I'll be cooking up a stew for dinner. But would you care to join me?
Huh? No, I...
All I have on me now is this apple. Here. Once your belly is full of warm food, you'll be able to pick yourself back up. I can feel it. Your body is shouting, I want to live.
I'm a disgrace. I don't deserve to live.
Is life something you have to earn? To deserve?
Well...
These feelings are natural. You eat when you're hungry and cry when you're sad. Feeling these things is proof that we're alive.
Alive?
What's your name? Mine is Celica. Celica Crow.
I'm an exorcist. Artori... No, Arthur. I'm Arthur.
Arthurius!
What in the world was that?
Rokuro! Aizen!
You saw it too then?
Sure did. Artorius. And he called himself Arthur.
I've heard of this. The Earth in Historia. They say that events on the world's surface cast imprints on the Earth pulse that runs below.
In other words, an illusion of the past.
It's not an illusion. That was my sister. So, he managed to fool her too, is it? Yes. Yes, that must be it. That's why she freed me from the prison.
Rokuro, have you recovered from your wounds?
Yep. Tough as nails, that's old Rokuro. I'm more worried about Velvet. She okay?
How could she be okay? Inominat is reborn, and it's her little brother.
A blade can't just be hard. It's gotta be flexible. Or it'll snap the first time it meets an unexpected force. I misunderstood the true meaning of strength, and so did he.
Let's just worry about ourselves for now. This Earth Pulse is completely under Inominat's domain. We can think of it as an extension of his body.
Yeah, which means my power won't get us out of here.
Be wary. Inominat may be the one showing us these memories. Remember, he's after Velvet.
And the two types of malevolence inside her.
True. And we may be able to use that against him to get us out of here.
What are you saying? Just use her?
If it's necessary.
We have to keep moving. Nothing will be gained by staying here. And we ought to look for Magilu. Even she doesn't deserve to be stuck here forever.
You know what?
We will need to be extremely wary.
Rising Falcon! Dragon!
In my way!
We will need to be extremely real!
So, what is this Earthen Historia you mentioned?
As I've said, an Earth Pulse is a natural force that circulates within the land. Wind blows, water flows, birds fly, flowers bloom. All actions in nature leave their mark on the Earth Pulse. These marks become etched within the land itself and remain a part of the Earth Pulse, like memories.
So it's a record of the world's past.
Does it remember human and Moloch deeds?
Everything that occurs is part of nature, including the acts of humans, Molochim, and even demons.
So that means that even this very conversation is being recorded in the Earthen Historia?
Anything bad I've done in secret, any insults you've ever told behind someone's back, the land sees it all.
My insults?
It's just an example. Pay it no mind.
Does that mean that Inominat is drawing specific memories from the Earthen Historia and showing them to Velvet?
I believe so. That's how Rokuro and I saw the same thing, even though we weren't there. With the Earth itself as his vessel, it's a trick only Inominat could pull off.
Awfully devious for a self-styled Empyrean.
But the attack did strike home. Keep a close watch on her until we're out of the Earth Pulse.
Right.
Velvet's psyche took a heavy blow there.
Yes. She's in rough shape.
How long do you think she'll last?
What do you mean?
Just what I said. Remember, hardness alone won't save you from breaking. If she keeps being shaken up like this, she won't be able to handle it.
But what can we do?
If she breaks, she breaks. Until then, we go on with our mission.
What? Can't we help her?
If you let sympathy fog your vision, you can end up crashed on a reef.
Even so, we can't just let her suffer. It's too much.
I'm fairly sure that Velvet would say the same thing if she was in Aizen's place.
And do you agree, Rokuro?
Me? I still have a debt to Velvet. I will pay it. But in the end, her fate will be something she'll have to decide for herself.
That's true, but...
Then I have a decision of my own to make. I won't give up on Velvet. No matter what.
I see. Do what you have to.
We won't stop you.
Annihilating?
had no problems here. Are we ready for this?
I said
he's
the one that inspired me!
Person
wins,
call in the spirit!
We're finished here.
Welcome home, Arthur.
Hi, Celica. I fixed the fence around the house.
Oh, thank you, sweetheart. With the brigands stepping up their attacks, the town elders have been worried. But this should put their minds at ease.
No. If the brigands turn into demons, a mere fence won't stop them.
Hmm?
Nothing. Don't worry about it. I'm pretty confident in my carpentry. And the other two?
Probably at the Cape again. I've warned them 100 times that it's dangerous.
Luffy set probably Badgered Velvet into going. Don't worry, she'll watch out for him.
Yeah, I can only hope that this little one grows up to be as strong as she is one day.
Huh?
You're happy, I hope.
Of course I am. I never thought I could ever be this happy. I only wish I'd known earlier. I would have made something even nicer for you.
Oh, you made this for me?
Yeah. I put all my heart into it.
I'll cherish it always. It'll remind me of this happy day.
Let this serve as proof of our love. This I swear. I swear to protect you both with my life.
That's Lord Artorias's past.
Oh, that's rich! You mean you believe that tripe?
It's all a pack of lies. His smile. His promise. Everything.
what we just saw. Was that from before the opening?
Yeah. Celica was there, and Artorias still had use of his arm. It didn't look like he was an exorcist either.
I never would have thought Lord Artorias could smile so tenderly.
But he's since become an exorcist, taking on the mantle of shepherd and the weight of the world.
All because he lost his beloved wife.
I'd understand if you wanted to back out. But at this rate, I think the time is coming. Not much longer now.
It's coming.
To think I ate up his lies without questioning a word. What a joke.
But I'm strong.
Velvet didn't know those things about Artorias and Celica, did she?
Probably not. That was when the two were alone and first getting to know each other.
We were seeing glimpses of a warm, loving family. But really, it just gave me the creeps.
Same here. I could keenly feel Enominat scheming behind everything we saw.
He's trying to get at Velvet.
I think she used to truly love Lord Artorias. Having that happy past thrust in front of her at a time like this must be tearing her apart.
Probably. But a demon like me wouldn't understand.
What Velvet is going through is horrible. Even as a human, I can scarcely imagine what it must be like. But I approach it, just a little bit. Because like her, I was his pupil.
Artorias said he needed two types of malevolence to awaken an Ominat. The illusions at a ball, making sure we knew about the attack on Titania, and Inominat appearing as her brother. If all of that was planned to extract the malevolence from her, we'd all better brace for worse to come.
Are we ready for this?
So many of them! Celica, I'm coming!
It's too late! Take Velvet and Lafayette and run!
I can't do that! I want to have my life with you! With our child! Why? Why couldn't I? Why couldn't I protect my own family?
Remember this moment well, Artorias. Humans are weak, filled with sin.
Melchior!
The people of this village offered you and your beloved family up to the demon brigands. A sacrifice, so that they could escape and hide.
No, they wouldn't.
It happens often. The reason people act on is burdened by the weight of their sins. However... I have found a method to adjust their reason.
A domain? What is this incredible power? Don't tell me the Imperium we've been searching for was here this whole time. These... Molochim...
So they have been reborn, but be not deceived. They are not the same people you knew.
Why? Why must fate be so cruel?
It appears that Innominut's resurrection is incomplete. We must guide him until we understand why. I'll be taking these Molochim.
Wait! I'm sorry I couldn't keep my promise. I'll make things right. I'll abandon who I am. Nameless Moloch, I will forge a pact with you. I will put an end to all the pain in this world.
Do you have it in you? You who abandoned my friend's ideals and fled.
On the souls of my dead master, wife, and child, this I swear. My name is Artorius Colbrand. I have inherited the will and the strength of Claudin Asgard, former head of the Exorcists.
Very well. Let tonight's tragedy change fate and birth salvation.
That Moloch, it was me. You don't remember?
Not at all.
They said you were reborn as a Moloch. That means... What exactly?
The soul of a human who passed away can, given the right trigger, be reborn as a Moloch.
You're saying that Artorius's child was reborn as Lafiset?
If what we saw was real, yes.
So the female Moloch that was born along with him was...
My sister's reincarnation. But I ate her long ago.
You didn't know, right?
I knew. I had already caught on to who Ceres really was.
Velvet.
But it doesn't matter. What does it change? I'll devour anything to fulfill my goal. My sister, my brother, even the world. That's who I am. That's all I am.
That was the day all of this started, wasn't it?
Yeah, the opening. Innominut was halfway revived and demons became visible to all.
His power also robbed almost every Moloch of their free will that day.
I never imagined that Lord Artorius's quest to change the world was so steeped in tragedy. The villagers should have never sold them out to those bandits.
It was cruel, yes, but nothing remarkable. People are capable of anything when under pressure. Even more so when they can do it under the mantle of the greater good. Velvet's family was probably the furthest outside the village circle that night.
That's pure selfishness.
Humans are selfish creatures. You should be aware of that by now.
That's why you said what you said just now, even if you didn't know it. Artorias' quest to change the world, not Artorias' quest to save humanity. I mean no disrespect. It's just an observation.
A man with the power to change the world turned his back on the potential of humanity. That may be the biggest tragedy of that night.
The savior of the world lost all hope in its people.
Aizen, you said a human soul can be reborn as a Moloch given the right trigger, right? Is that something that happens frequently?
I'm afraid I don't have an answer for that. We know that humans are sometimes reborn as Molochim, but not how or why. It's more likely among people with greater resonance, but the process is still a mystery.
Huh. So it's not something that happens, or that can be made to happen, easily, ordinarily at least.
But Velvet's sister was reborn as Ceres, and her unborn child came back as Lafayette. What are the chances of that?
It might not have been chance. They both died on the Scarlet Night. Their rebirths may have been influenced by the sacrificial ceremony.
Are you saying that Ennominot made it happen on purpose?
Call it an educated guess. But I don't think even an Empyrean can control the lives of humans or Molochim at his whim.
If it wasn't chance, it might have been destiny.
Velvet said she ate Ceres, her own sister reborn as a Moloch. How could such a horrible thing be destiny?
Sorry. I didn't mean to make light of a tragedy, but our fates intertwine, the good and the bad, whether we like it or not. That's what makes it destiny, right?
True. But this...
Get a hold of yourself, Eleanor. Velvet and Lafayette are in rougher waters than any of us. They'll be looking to you to light their way.
Yes. I must remain calm and steady.